You must be Agent Thornton. I understand you have some important information for me.
Yeah, I'm here to save your life. You should really listen to me. The Chinese are planning to kill you and set off massive riots at your rally this week.
This is a troubling development, Agent Thornton. If it is true.
You think I'm making it up?
Let us just say I would like to hear the whole story before I make any decisions. A man with my political views lives with threats every day. If you can present me with compelling evidence of this plot, I will take action.
Look, Mr. President, I didn't fly halfway around the world to play practical jokes on world leaders. This is real.
You must see it from my perspective. With no hard evidence, I can't simply change my plans.
I have evidence of the assassination.
Then the riots are merely your conjecture.
No, sir, Mr. President. Both threats are genuine. Please, for your safety, cancel your appearance at the rally.
Canceling the rally at this juncture would do considerable harm to my cause. I am afraid it is out of the question.
Then at least take extra precautions. Wear body armor during your speech. Post extra security, something.
Give me your evidence, Agent Thornton. If my security chief concurs that the threat is credible, I'm sure he will insist on my wearing a vest during the speech.
If
I have security silence dissenters in the crowd, I look like a petty dictator. I am sorry, but without hard evidence, I will not send that message to my people.
Here's everything I have. Of course, if you listen to me, you could prevent both of these outcomes.
Perhaps, Agent Thornton. But I cannot act on the word of a foreign intelligence agent alone. What comes will come, and Taiwan will weather it as she always has.
How'd it go?
Could have been better.
He didn't listen?
I gave him the evidence on the assassination plot, but without proof of the riot phase of the plan, he refused to place extra security in the crowd.
What are you going to do?
What I do best, shoot up a bunch of bad guys and save the day.
Well, don't let me stand in your way.
Mike, how did it go with Sung?
He gave me half of his attention. He's still in danger.
So he didn't believe you?
He believed the assassination plot, but refused to take precautions against the riots.
So he didn't believe you?
No.
You tried, Mike. And helping you out? Well, you certainly keep things interesting.
That's one way to put it. I'm betting things are going to get a lot more interesting soon enough.
We'll figure something out, Mike. If not, well, then I think we'll have a larger story than either of us want.
Are you planning to stay in Taipei, then?
Now I am. That is, if you think I can help, Mike. I don't know what I can do, but...
It's better if you stay out of the way from now on. I think it's gonna get a lot more violent from here on out.
If so, then I'm not going anywhere. I'll try to gather what I can from my contacts, Mike. Until then...
If I need any more help, I'll let you know. Thanks for everything, Scarlett.
Good luck, Mike. And good luck with Sung.
Looks like Deng's men already made it here. How's that satellite uplink, Mina?
Working. And you're right, satellite imaging shows Chinese secret police all throughout the parks. We're a little late.
Steven, what's it looking like near the stage?
It's a madhouse over here. But not in that fun, violent way.
This should be interesting.
You better hurry, Mike. Sung's giving his speech in less than an hour.
Speech? Weren't we here just for the fireworks?
Yes, Mike. That and a little thing called regional stability.
Follow
I bet those explosives are controlled from here.
Firing charges!
Gate should be all clear now. Thank you. pretty.
The noise from those fireworks should cover the sound of gunfire. You might be able to use that.
Thank you.
these fancy pyrotechnics do. Coming onto the stage. It's a straight shot from where you are.
I didn't think you were one to hide, Deng. You're missing your big opportunity. Show yourself.
No. It ends. You're in.
Deng must have had an accomplice in the crowd. I tried to warn him. I sent him everything I had in the assassination attempt.
Mike, emergency frequencies are reporting riots breaking out. And they're getting ugly. Additional security forces are en route.
And you don't think they'll believe the guy holding a smoking gun when he says he didn't do it?
Somehow I doubt it.
tragedy was averted today when an assassination attempt on Taiwanese President Ronald Sung proved unsuccessful. Government spokesmen say the president was warned about the attempt earlier this week by an anonymous source, which convinced him to wear a bulletproof vest during his speech. The president was taken to Taipei City Hospital, where he is reported to be in stable condition. News of the president's survival was not enough to quell riots that broke out shortly after the attack. Police say instigators within the crowd convinced spectators that the attack was part of a Chinese plot, which sparked the riot that has so far killed 23 people. Police discovered the body of a man believed to be the assassin on the roof of a nearby building. The alleged assassin's name has not been released, but authorities are saying he committed suicide once the attempt on President Sun's life failed.
Heck, calling Thornton. Come in, Thornton.
Yeah, Heck, I'm here.
Just a heads up, Mike. There's some folks out there that really hate you, pal.
I suppose it's too much to hope that you did unspeakable things to them.
So this VCI comes to me and he says to me, Steve, I got a proposition for you.
It's kind of busy here, Heck. Is there a point to this?
So after I pop three of his fingers off for calling me Steve, I say, and what proposition might that be, my good man?
Heck?
This guy says to me, oh God, please don't kill me. I just came here to offer you $5 million to give Michael Thornton up as Ronald Sung's assassin.
Tell me you didn't.
Not gonna lie, buddy. I was really tempted for a minute there. But I kind of like you, so I told him to piss off. Then I set him on fire to make sure he got the point.
Shouldn't you have stabbed him to make sure he got the point?
I figured his cronies would probably try and find somebody less scrupulous than myself. So I went ahead and called the news stations. Should keep them off your back for a while.
I appreciate that.
Hey, no problem, buddy. I want to lay low for a while, but I'll be in touch. Be seeing you, Mike.
Searching for a man called Wen Xu in connection with the attack. Government sources have told INN that Wen Xu is a Taiwanese national with no previous criminal record. The nature of his involvement remains to be seen.
That should buy me a little time to get out of Taipei. Better get moving.
And so this is the result of your efforts in Taipei. Chaos in the streets, an assassination attempt against the president of Taiwan. Well done.
The president survived, the riots are dying down. I think I did okay.
Hardly. As far as the Taiwanese are concerned, Omen Deng shot their president. Soon it will leak that Deng was a member of the Chinese secret police, and the push for independence will become even stronger. You managed to escape Taipei undetected, largely because of an anonymous tip identifying a man called Wen Xu as the attempted assassin. Stephen Heck's work, I trust?
Professional favor. Now I owe him one. It's pretty much how the spy business works.
That's not like you. I've read the records. Seems like you've alienated almost everyone you've worked with since you've activated Alpha Protocol.
I prefer to work alone. That's all you cared about then? Destabilizing Taipei?
You should pay more attention to global politics, Agent Thornton. If Taipei pushes for independence, the People's Republic will prepare for war. If China prepares for war, so does the US.
And we rename egg rolls freedom rolls.
Something like that.
Tragedy was averted today when an assassination.
Welcome to Moscow, Mike. How do you like your new apartment?
This is what we're spending taxpayer money on? Fancy apartments and designer furniture?
You'd prefer a rat hole in the bad part of town with no internet and dodgy electricity?
I'd prefer something a little more discreet.
That building is one of the most exclusive in Moscow. Nobody gets in without invitation, and nobody talks to the press. That's the definition of discreet. All right, down to business then. Do you have a plan of attack for Moscow?
It's amazing how much the promise of a trip to Gitmo can loosen people's tongues.
Not exactly a win friends and influence people approach, but it might get you somewhere. What will you follow up on first?
Not sure yet. The missile launchers were moved through Leningradsky Station. There might be intel there. I've also got a CIA informant codenamed Grigori and a mob underboss called Lazo.
Finding those missiles is important, although more information would be helpful. But from his file, Grigori looks like the type who would sell information about you to interested parties. Lazo might be able to provide some leads, too.
Plus, they might be able to tell me what bars and strip joints I should hit while I'm here.
Charming, Mike.
Just having a little fun. Or did your sense of humor get removed at birth?
Maybe when you say something amusing, you'll see it.
Tragedy was averted today when an assassination attempt on Taiwanese President Ronald
It's signed,
Sun
Good Times, Stephen Heck.
Government spokesmen say the president was warned about the attempt earlier this week by an anonymous source, which convinced him to wear a bulletproof vest during his speech. The president was taken to Taipei City Hospital, where doctors described his condition as shaken but stable. News of the president's survival was not enough to quell riots that broke out shortly after the attack.